missed the slash. Kovalev, paying attention to whether his hand's broken, ends up running into Suri. That's when the breakaway happens.
This past spring, the Habs and Bruins met in the playoffs for the 33rd time in their history, and for a sixth time, it went to seven games.
Lucic, top of the circle, Horton, the drive, score! The Bruins knock out Montreal!
In the 1988 Adams Division Final, the second-ranked Bruins knocked off the number one Habs in five games, the first playoff win against the rival in 19 tries.
And the ghosts have disappeared. The Bruins have eliminated the Montreal Canadiens.
In the NHL, oh, hold on.
Oh, my goodness! Oh, my. Max Pacioretty is down, and this looks scary.
Chara's hit set off a firestorm in Montreal, with fans and local media calling for Chara to be charged. The hit is still under investigation by Quebec's Crown Office. John Cordick and Jay Miller fought each other eight times during their NHL careers, highlighted by this bout, November 12, 1987. After the fight, Miller says, "We're number one," to the Habs bench.
Now, look out. The bottom of the corner. Here comes Tim Thomas. Here comes Thomas. How does he go with it? The referee's going to let him go.
He better be tough. I'll tell you that.
Price and Thomas.
This original six thing is on.
Thomas and Price's bout was one of 12 fighting majors in the game, which had a combined 182 penalty minutes. In the 1971 quarterfinals, Ken Dryden backstopped Montreal to a huge upset over the heavily favored Bruins. The Habs went on to win the cup.
Now Jonathan and Bouchard, here they go. Jonathan and Pierre Bouchard. Bouchard pounding away with the right hand. Now Jonathan with the left hand. And falls on top of Bouchard. I think John D'Amico is caught too.
In November 1986, a spirited tilt between Cam Neely and rookie Shane Corson ratcheted up the intensity. Later in the game, Chris Nyland was being escorted off the ice after his fight, and that's when things got even nastier.
Nyland. Oh, Nyland took a swing at Lindsman. Here we go. Now this will clear the benches. Here we go. Terry O'Reilly trying to hold off Mike McPhee and Patrick Roy. There may not be anybody left to finish the second period.
Game 7 of the 1979 Stanley Cup semifinal. Late in the third, with the Bruins up one, Boston was called for too many men on the ice, and Guy Lafleur took advantage.
He gets it into Lemaire, back to Lafleur.
Yvon Lambert scored the OT winner, and the Habs went on to win the Stanley Cup.